Here's another example. You have an image, and you want your network to say, it's an image with a cat in it. It doesn't really matter whether cat is, it's still an image with a cat. If your network has to learn about kittens in the left corner and about kittens in the right corner independently, that's a lot of work that it has to do. How about you telling it instead explicitly that objects in images are largely the same whether they're on the left or on the right of the picture? That's what's called translation invariance. Different positions, same kitten. Yet another example. Imagine you have a long text that talks about kittens. Does the meaning of kitten change depending on whether it's in the first sentence or in the second one? Mostly not. So if you train a network on text, maybe you want the part of the network that learns what a kitten is to be reused every time you see the word kitten and not have to relearn it every time. The way you achieve this in neural networks is using what's called weight sharing. When you know that two inputs can contain the same kind of information, then you share their weights and train the weights jointly for those inputs. It's a very important idea. Statistical invariance, things that don't change on average across time or space, are everywhere. For images, the idea of weight sharing will get us to study convolutional networks. For text and sequences in general, it will lead us to embeddings and recurrent neural networks.